My name is Shawn Morrison, and I am the captain of the Seton Hall men's soccer team. Typically, my week starts out on Monday with a recovery session from this past week's games that occurred on the weekend. You know, we'll go in with a training session, something light, kind of get the bones and muscles moving. And then Tuesday will be a travel day for our games on Wednesday. A typical week for me consists of about two games, one away and one home game, and you know, we play in the Big East, so a lot of our competition is based out of the Midwest. You know, we travel to Chicago, we play DePaul, we travel to Xavier out in Cincinnati, and these trips take time to get there. So one week we'll hop on a flight in the morning, spend the whole day traveling, get to the hotel, spend the night. The next day we'll have our game, you know, shower, take care of ourselves, then we'll hop on a plane and fly back, and all of that after we get back, that's about 3 days of the week. There's a lot of positives of being a student athlete. This is my first year being a captain for the Seton Hall men's program, and I think it's helped me develop these leadership skills, and in the long run, no matter where I end up, I think these skills are going to benefit me.
So I've been playing soccer and playing sports for a long time now. It's, you know, been the biggest part of my life for forever now, and I've had a lot of captains and a lot of leaders and a lot of people that think that, you know, they know what they're doing, but a lot of the times those guys just talk a lot of talk and don't really walk the walk. I know it's a cliche, but you know, it's hard to find a leader that, you know, will say the right things and then will do the right thing as well. So Shawn, I think, really personifies both saying and doing the right things.
The best way to describe Shawn is a developed leader, and a developed leader to me is the best kind of leader. Someone who's started at the bottom, you know, didn't come in thinking that they could tell people what to do, that they were better than people, that they were above. He was someone who came at the bottom, very, very modest, very humble, want to listen, you know, want to gather experiences, want to listen to people older, had respect. And when the time came, Shawn naturally just rolled into that leadership position.
One area of my life that suffers being a student athlete is my social life, because it's not like I cannot do my homework or not do soccer. I have to do those two, so one place I have to take time from is my social life. My girlfriend Laurel is a cheerleader, who she's also a student athlete, so I think it's great to have someone like that in my life, because she also understands that there's not every second in the world for her, and she has to fit me into her schedule, and I have to fit her into my schedule when she's in season. So it's great having that, you know, balancing person in your life that's able to deal with it. Although being a student athlete may seem very time consuming and challenging to manage, I think overall it's been a great experience and helps build my character every single day. I'm constantly learning and putting myself in better situations to prepare myself for the future, so there's not much I would trade in the world than to be a student athlete.